Hi, I'm Nadia Nazir. This is TV Sarawak Prime News. Sarawak Regatta will be continued to be given focus by Ministry of Tourism as it translates Sarawak's history and tradition. This was stressed by Chief Minister Tan Sri Dato' Amar Adnan Satim when launching the annual event. This time around, the 142nd Sarawak Regatta is different with addition of the Dragon Boat Race, which attracted paddlers from Canada, Australia, Hong Kong, Macau, Brunei, Taiwan, Singapore, Indonesia, the Philippines and Thailand. Tan Sri Adnan added that the Dragon Boat has added zest to the event, especially with foreigners' participation. He also expressed his hope that in future Sarawak Regatta, more foreigners would participate. Tourism Minister Dato' Amar Abang Johari Tun Oping was also present in the event. The Sultan of Brunei, Sultan Hassan Al-Bolkiah, is expected to watch the Sarawak Regatta 2014. He is expected to be accompanied by Sarawak Yang di-Pertua Negeri Tun Pihin Sri Abdul Taib Mahmud. The 142nd edition of the regatta was officiated by Chief Minister Tan Sri Dato' Amar Adnan Satim. Sarakup Indu Dayak Sarawak SIDS Chairwoman Datuk Sri Empiang Jabu called all parents to ensure their children work hard in order to excel in their studies. Excelling in studies ensures a brighter future as it opens doors to many opportunities and the ability to compete. It was noted that many Iban still lag behind other communities in terms of academic and technical skills. She added that the government has prepared financial aids to help students pursue their education. Tony Abbott said that he is committed to assist Malaysia in the search for the missing MH370 and the criminals behind the shooting down of MH17. He noted that the tragedies has brought both countries to closer ties. He also said that Malaysia and Australia would contribute 180 million ringgit each to locate MH370. The Prime Minister of Australia was on an official visit to Malaysia. The Royal Malaysian Police PDRM investigating team will be departing to Ukraine on 8 September 2014 to continue investigations pertaining to flight MH17's crash following the ceasefire between pro-Russian separatists and the Ukraine government. The group of 30 officers will be led by Internal Security and Public Order Deputy Director Datuk Muhammad Fuad Abu Zarim. Another 50 officers will be leaving later. Putrajaya considered ISIS as a terrorist organisation, said Wisma Putra last week. This was further reiterated by Prime Minister Najib Tun Razak as he considered ISIS as a misnomer and does no justice to Islam. Malaysia would cooperate with international community to combat against ISIS. A coalition of NATO allies is ready to join the United States in military action against Islamic State IS, US President Obama has announced. Speaking at the NATO summit in Wales, he said that a core coalition has been formed to tackle the threat. US Defense Secretary Chuck Hagel said the group would be the US, Britain, Australia, Canada, Denmark, France, Germany, Italy, Poland and Turkey. President Obama and Secretary of State John Kerry have sought to use the gathering of ministers at the summit to enlist more countries in the fight against IS in Iraq, but ruled out the use of ground troops. Kurdish forces in northern Iraq have recaptured a strategically important mountain from Islamic State IS militants helped by US airstrikes. The mountain fell to the Islamists last month when they staged a lightning attack on Iraqi Kurdistan. The BBC's Jim Weir in Iraq says Mount Zartak was retaken in a short, sharp battle that left more than 30 IS fighters dead. IS, also known as ISIS, has taken over swaths of Iraq and Syria in recent months, declaring the land it holds a caliphate. The United Nations and human rights groups have accused IS of committing atrocities, including mass killings of ethnic and religious minorities. Muhammad T. Asif Abdul Muttalib has made his mark as one of the world's top riders at the Alltech FEI World Equestrian Games 2014, dubbed as the planet's most prestigious international equestrian event. The 17-year-old teenager, who is the youngest competitor among riders from 72 nations, successfully completed the endurance category, where he clinched 27th position in the games held in Normandy, France. Asif, wearing his riding gear and helmet in Jalo Gemilang colors, said that he is happy to have achieved his goal of being World Junior Elite Rider. Kei Nishikori beat world number one Novak Djokovic at the US Open to become the first Asian man to reach a Grand Slam final. He won 6-4, 1-6, 7-6, 6-3. While the rest of the tennis world was left stunned, Nishikori said he was only a little bit surprised to have denied Djokovic a fifth successive trip to the Flushing Meadows final. He said that he is very happy to have made history and looks forward to create another history by winning the US Open to become the first Asian to achieve it. Malaysia will host the inaugural ASEAN Football Federation AFF Beach Soccer Championship. The tournament will be held in Kuantan from 21st to 31st October next month. The AFF Beach Soccer Championship is sponsored by Malaysia's Federal Land Development Authority, also known as FELDA, with a total contribution of 1 million ringgit. China's biggest e-commerce firm Alibaba Group Holdings says it expects to price its initial public offering IPO at between $60 and $66 per share. It has filed to sell up to $24.3 billion in stock in what will be the biggest technology listing in the US. Facebook's IPO, which raised $16 billion in 2012, was the previous biggest share sale for an internet company.
但我真觉得很好奇，居然还走了那么多年，而且居然还活着。啊，我从九五年年九五年年初九四年年底我就开始做互联网，中国其实商业应用，做互联网的商业，我应该是第一个。我比银海威其实早半年。
Alibaba accounts for 80% of all online retail sales in China. Its sites also include Taobao, Tmall, and AliExpress. Facebook's IPO gave it a market value of more than $100 billion. Alibaba's IPO would give it a market value of up to $162 billion. The company is selling 123.1 million of the 320.1 million shares in the IPO. Especially for teachers, we have put up a video which rounds up some of the best websites and apps to aid in teaching. You can watch the video in our site under the title Webscape Teaching and Learning Resources. To all coffee lovers who are concerned about caffeine, rest assured that scientists are working hard to come up with decaf coffee using sequenced genome. The research could lead to decaf coffee that doesn't taste like you're licking a battery. Currently, beans are decaffeinated via chemical processes that affect flavor. Now that scientists have identified which genes produce caffeine, they may be able to deactivate them selectively, preserving more of the traditional coffee taste. Sequencing the genome could help researchers bolster coffee's immunity against diseases or maybe even help the plant cope with climate change.
Here I have a disc. Those are ready for the bin. I'm not sure if they can be recycled. If you know whether they can be recycled, please leave us a message. So you can either stir that or you can keep it like that. So I think you'll agree that is really rather impressive, and it is absolutely glorious smell. So all we really need now is a willing volunteer for my coffee.
That was the Prime News on TV Sarawak. I'm Nadia Nazir, leaving you with a quote from Khalil Gibran.